On popular demand, today I'll be talking about oral contraceptive pills and acne. Most of my viewers had asked this question in the comment section, and some of them did send me a personal request to talk about it. Oral contraceptive pills are basically of two types, one that contains only progesterone and one that contains a combination of a derivative of estrogen and progesterone, which is commonly used and prescribed. Now, the estrogen part in a oral contraceptive pill increases the protein that binds to the androgen. We all know that hormonal imbalance happens when there is an increase in the androgen level of the body, or there is an increase in the sensitivity of receptors towards androgen. So estrogen increases the protein which binds to the circulating androgen and hence decreasing the level. Progesterone may help inhibit the enzyme 5-alpha reductase. This is a very popular and notorious enzyme because it converts testosterone into dihydrotestosterone, which is more potent and powerful. Progesterone inhibits the synthesis of dihydrotestosterone. So, what are the indications of using oral contraceptive pills in acne? Number one, if the patient has evidence of, polycystic ovarian syndrome and patient has a history of irregular cycles, this may be beneficial in improving the both. Number two, if the acne is not responding to the conventional treatments, the acne is more, along jawline, and there is a history of, when investigated, the patient had increased levels of not only testosterone, free testosterone, but an enzyme known as DHEAS. In those cases also, oral contraceptive pills may be helpful. Oral contraceptive pills are generally prescribed in acne, which has a hormonal basis, and there is documented evidence to prove the increased level of androgens or androgen sensitivity in a patient. What are the contraindications of using oral birth pill, we call as birth control pills or oral contraceptive pills? Number one, if the patient is pregnant or breastfeeding, it cannot be given. If the patient is more than 35 years of age, there is certainly not so prescribed. If patient has history of thromboembolism or clot formation in the family, there is a strong family history of stroke or deep vein thrombosis or DVT, then it's a big no-no. Then again, history of any cancer, immunosuppression is also a big no for prescribing oral contraceptive pills. If the patient is going to be subjected to a prolonged period of immobilization or a surgery is planned where the patient will not be able to walk for a couple of days due to any reason, this also is a reason of not prescribing oral contraceptive pills. So oral contraceptive pills are generally prescribed in conjunction with a gynecologist opinion, and if a plain oral contraceptive pill is not able to help your hormonal acne, then an anti-androgen like cipriterone acetate or spironolactone may also be considered. My dear friends, the risk-benefit ratio of oral contraceptive pills in acne shall be measured by a dermatologist. An opinion from gynecologist should also be sought before starting a patient on OCPs. Even an endocrinologist may be of helpful opinion. There should be a documented evidence of increased androgen level or androgen sensitivity in a patient before we prescribe oral contraceptive pills or birth control pills. Progesterone containing oral contraceptive pills may sometimes worsen acne for a short duration. Please consult a dermatologist at the earliest before starting anything like this on your own. Thank you.